there is no replacement for experience. So we have some guys who have some experience from last year that's experienced both playing for me and experience in games. You know, there are three guys that returned that had significant roles on our team. You know, Andrew Fleming obviously is the most notable one, Sergio Eldarwich and Bill Gott Larson as well. Mix Antom's played some as off the bench as well. So we've got those four guys returning. We also have four guys who redshirted last year, so they were either in practice or at least around practice, watching, learning, and I think are further along because of that experience. And so Misha, Sali, Steph, and Neja are those four, and all four are doing a good job so far. And we have 14 games in our non-conference schedule. Pretty strong non-conference. We play games like Virginia, Washington, Harvard, all on the road. Those all three teams are in somebody's top 25 preseason. They're really good teams. They're veteran teams, got a lot coming back. So we'll definitely be tested in our non-conference schedule. Games at home include teams like Quinnipiac, who we had a big lead at halftime but lost to them last year on the road. Dartmouth, who I think is will be a competitive game for us. Columbia from the Ivy League, and another team that really talented, some really good players in the Ivy League. It's a good league, and looking forward to kind of matching wits with them. We start off with Merrimack. Merrimack is transitional Division I, but they probably would have been picked to win the Division II National Championship last year. Bookies probably have them as the favorite playing here in that first game. So anyone who thinks that's going to be an easy one is mistaken. They shoot threes, they junk defense, play a lot of zone, got really good guard play, guys who can fill it up. So that's a tough test even right out of the gate. So we have definitely have our work cut out for us, but I think that this team will grow through the non-conference schedule, and I think we'll be ready once conference play arrives. Well, America East starts in January, so how prepared we are has a lot to do with what happens over the next 2+ months, and the games that we play certainly are part of that, but every bit of it's, practice too. And we have 11 guys who didn't play last year that are playing, so that's a lot of people to integrate. That's a lot of things to figure out, chemistry to build. I think we have to have some patience, in terms of getting there. At the same time, I think we all have a real sense of urgency because we want to be good, not only for ourselves, but for Maine. We believe Maine deserves a really good men's basketball team, and we've got some guys who are working really hard to make that happen. But there are some things, like we talked about, experience, that you just can't substitute. And so what happens over these next 2 months will really determine how we head into conference play. Consistency every day in practice, consistency in our games, consistency from our individual performers. We would have letdowns in games that would cost us games. And so, the record was what it was, and that's who we were. And we can't run from that, we can't shy from that, we can't say just because we were competitive in games that we were better than that record. No, we were what the record was. We've got to own that. At the same time, I don't think the record indicates the potential, and it may not show how close we are to getting better. So, athletics is the magnification of small differences. And the difference between a University of Vermont, who's a preseason top 40 team nationally, and the University of Maine is not that they score 200 points a game and we score 40. It's the small differences that add up over time. It's being operating at 55% efficiency instead of 48% efficiency. It's shooting 45% as a team instead of 42% as a team. It's the difference between making one or two more shots a game or not forcing one or two passes. It's the difference between waiting on a screen and coming off and your teammate gets called for an illegal screen because you didn't wait. It's those subtle things, the accumulation of those things ends up being the result of a game, a win or a loss. And then, of course, those results are then magnified over the course of a season. We're not as far as maybe the record would indicate, but if we don't do those things and we don't play with consistency, we'll probably be right back where we were.
owe you guys.
Yeah. Well, I think we're still figuring that out. I think what's true is that we have talented players. We have some a nice mix of skill, size, and ability, right? And we also have good guys. I think they're committed to doing things the way we're asking them to do them. There's still a learning process with that. That doesn't just happen overnight. But I think their commitment level's high. They're character kids, people that we enjoy being around. People that I enjoy having over to my house for dinner, you know, kids that that I would feel very comfortable bringing small children around and letting them be role models. So I think all those things are a start, but how we put those pieces together again over the next 2 months will really determine not just this season, but also kind of the established culture moving forward. Well, I want to see constant improvement. You know, my experience is in the second year of being a coach at a program, that's really like starting over. The first year is kind of putting a bow on the previous coach's tenure. It's learning new ways of doing things. It's adjusting, getting your feet wet, developing strategies. After the first year, you have an idea of kind of what you want to do, and then you start it. And so that's been my experience. So I think this is just the beginning. I think this is where we really try to establish culture, identity. Somewhat style of play, character, what we expect on a daily basis. And as we start to see some consistency in those things, both because we're doing a better job as coaches and also because our guys are understanding it and meeting expectations each day, I think then the play improves. It's happened everywhere I've been, and so I'm looking forward to seeing the same thing happen here at Maine.